So I have increased, I'm increasing my values from 10 degrees, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, 40 degrees, 50 degrees, and I'm observing all the refracted rays. And I am noting down in my tabular column what is the angles of incidence and what is the angle of reflection, refraction. This is nothing but angle of refraction. Now, when I have observed this, that means when the angle is 10 degrees, 20 degrees, and 30 degrees, these are the angles of incidence, and I have measured the angles of refraction also. I have measured the angles of refraction at a particular angle of incidence. I already told you, for 10 degrees, this is the angle of refraction. 20 degrees, this is the angle of refraction. For 30 degrees, angle of refraction. So as you go on increasing, that means angle of incidence, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. When the angle of incidence is increasing, at a particular angle of incidence, at a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray, this is the refracted ray traces along the interface line. For example, at this particular angle, the refracted ray is tracing along the interface line. This angle is called critical angle. This is called critical angle. Children, did you understand what is critical angle? You are slowly increasing your angle of incidence. That means 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90. You are increasing the angle of incidence. When you are increasing, you are getting the refracted rays. This is angle of incidence, and you are getting the refracted rays on the other side. Both the angle of incidence and angle of refraction, you are going to find out or know down in the tabular column. When you are slowly increasing from 10 to 90, 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on, when you are increasing the angle of incidence, at a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray traces along the interface line. At what angle it is tracing the interface line? This angle is, that particular angle is called critical angle. So what is critical angle, children? At particular angle of incidence, at a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray is tracing, this is interface line. At a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray is tracing the interface line. So at a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray traces the interface, separating this is air medium and this is glass medium. So children, did you understand what is critical angle? At a particular angle of incidence, at a particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray grazes the interface line. That angle, that particular angle, for example, if it is at 80 degrees, it is tracing the interface line. That means angle of critical angle is 80 degrees. So, in the same manner, what is critical angle? At particular angle of incidence, the refracted ray traces the interface, separating the air and glass, is called critical angle. If the angle of incidence, if the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle I measure, I am denoting by IC. I means angle of incidence. IC means critical angle. If angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, if the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, the ray whatever you are focusing, you should get the refracted ray. This is incident ray and this is the refracted ray. But if angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, at that particular circumstance, the light, we are not getting the refracted ray. The light, whatever you have refracted, it never enters from denser to rarer. But again, the ray will be reflected at a particular angle. But that means when the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, at that angle, the light ray never enters into the rarer medium. But for example, if you, this is your incident light, at that particular light, at that particular constant, the light ray is reflected back into the same medium. This is called total internal reflection. Children, did you understand? When the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, light ray never enters into the other medium, but it comes back into the same path. Here you have focused the light. The reflected light is also in the same plane. That totally it is reflected back. The light ray never enters into the other medium, but will be reflected back completely. This is called total internal reflection.